It's a long time series. There aren't very many time series in Antarctica that long. And over that time, the regional population has increased by a factor of 6. So it used to be about 30,000 breeding pairs, and now it's almost 200,000 breeding pairs. That's nearly 500,000 breeding birds. So it's a very large population in the Windmill Islands, the third largest in East Antarctica. We also realised that some populations were still going gangbusters in terms of growing at very fast rates, and some were flatlining, so they were not changing at all. What we've found is that the populations that are stable don't have much breeding habitat left. So they've expanded in their growth in previous years and virtually filled that habitat, so they can't grow anymore. We found that the populations that have been increasing quickly have a lot of habitat left. Good breeding habitat on land is ice-free land, snow-free land, not too steep, not flat because flat gets too wet, and with lots of pebbles so they can build their nests. So we can count them from helicopters flying overhead, taking photos and counting the penguins from the photos. Or if we can get to an island, we can do a direct count from the ground. It's not a trivial task. There are tens and hundreds of thousands of penguins in this population, so it's a very difficult and time-consuming thing to do.
I looked at 10 photos per day for every season, and I did 10 seasons, and at the 5 camera sites. Stealing rocks from other penguins, that's a major thing that they do. They'll just go take rocks, no permission asked, and then take that back to their nest. Otherwise, they'll just go scrounging for rocks around the colony as well. So the higher the nest off the ground, the more likely they are to be away from the snow cover and the moisture on the ground. So we weren't expecting that nest structure would have such a big impact on breeding success, because that was a relatively new finding. Only a few people prior to me have found that.
We've been focusing on Adélie penguins all this time, but the penguins are part of a larger ecosystem, and what we're trying to understand is how that larger ecosystem works.
So all the expeditioners who went down in that 10-year period I was looking at, need to thank them so much for giving me and other people the opportunity to find out as much as we can about Adélie penguins to help them into the future.